Christmas, a Christmas present for all who will accept it. Our almighty, all-powerful, creator of all that exist was moved to an excessive, extreme, by his love for you and me, so, stirred that he was, he did the almost unthinkable to save us, he became like us for a short period. Philippians 2:6-8, though Jesus was God, he did not think of equality with God as something to cling to. Instead, he gave up his divine privileges, he took the humble position of a slave and was born as a human being. When he appeared in human form, he humbled himself in obedience to God and died a criminal's death on a cross. What we do see is Jesus, who was given a position a little lower than the angels, and because he suffered death for us, he is now crowned with glory and honor. Yes, by God's grace, Jesus tasted death for everyone. Hebrews 2:9. Why would God have to do such a thing? Because he is righteous and holy, his law demands a death for each sin, and God does not place even himself above his own law. Therefore, all who sin must pay the penalty. His word tells us that all have sinned and fall short of the demands of God's law, consequently, all of us deserve the death penalty. But God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, as a propitiation, an acceptable substitute so that everyone who believes in him will not perish but have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world that he might condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Anyone who believes in him is not condemned, but anyone who does not believe is already condemned because he has not believed in the name of the one and only Son of God. John 3:16-18 HCSB. Do you recall any of the presents that you were given more than a few years ago? Of course not, but when you willingly received the eternal presence of Christ in your being, then you have the one present that keeps on giving, eternally.